All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Spotlight Musical Theater. Thank you. My name is Stephanie Newland, and I'm the director of Belong Disability Ministry here at HPUMC. And I am, thank you. I am here to welcome you, and thank you so much for spending your Sunday evening here with us. You will have a wonderful time, I have no doubt. And I'm going to pass it on to Lisa, our director, to talk a little bit more about how this show came to be.
Hi. Wow, it is so fantastic to see so many people out here. This is actually my 12th production, 13 years. We had that one pandemic year. So first, I want to see a show of hands. Who has seen one of these shows before? Let me see a show of hands. Wow! Now that's some fans. Thank you for coming back. You know what to expect. So I'm going to do a little bit of housekeeping. If there are any babies in the house that feel the urge to cry, please take your adult out into the lobby with you and watch the show from the peace and quiet back out there. Also, somebody asked me, can I take pictures? Yeah, you can take pictures as long as you don't use a flash. The flash will disturb the actors, so feel free to snap away as long as no flashes are happening. So I have been doing this. I absolutely love it. I was introduced by Raphael Perry here, one of my friends and artistic director for the Shakespeare Festival, and he said, hey, I think this is going to be something you love to do because you like to work with non-traditional casts. You like to work with people who are not the professional actors, and I do. I love it so much more because I feel like that's the real roots of theater, right? Theater is about the actors getting to say what is in their hearts. And that's how we came to create these plays each year. So the first thing we do way back in September is we come together, we sit in a circle. We always sit in circles so that we all feel equal. There's not a leader, we're all the same. And I say, what's important to you? What's on your mind? And some of our players were very concerned about the international conflicts that are going on right now. Of course, we have wars going on, and they said that's something that worries them. Another cast member said, I am very concerned about divorce and split families and mixed families and how they make it together. And I was like, okay, so we're gonna have conflict, like a territorial conflict, but we're also gonna have these mixed families. I was like, okay, I'm starting to see how we might be able to create a play. And then they said, well, wait a second, we also love country music. So George Gagliardi, our composer, George, wave there. George is like, okay, I got it. I can write some country music. And then, of course, some of the other cast said, but wait, I love 80s pop. So that came in, too. So we got that going, too. And then we had one actor who said, I have to be a lawyer. And I said, no problem. We'll work a lawyer. And then I had another actor say, and we need Elvis in the show because the Elvis movie said just happened. So I'm just going to give you a warning. You could look for all that in the play. We did our best to work it in and still have a plot that hung together. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, the people behind this curtain are really scared. They're very nervous. I mean, just imagine if you wrote your own play, right? You wrote the words, and you're up there singing and saying them to an audience of hundreds. We know what that's like, right? It's terrifying. And so they're really scared back there right now. And unlike other theater productions where the audience sits back and waits to be inspired and entertained, today you are part of this program, this experiment, right? Because you are going to feed your energy up to these players so that they can feel your love, feel your support. So I need you right now. We're going to practice. I want you to practice. And imagine somebody screwed up, okay? Maybe they didn't get the line out, but they finally got it out, right? And they did it. I want you to let them hear how much you're going to support them. All right. Okay, I think we've got it. You guys are ready. We up ready up in the balcony up there? There's our balcony people. Okay, please enjoy. Who's hollow?
A gentle breeze is blowing. Here comes the sunrise. The birds are softly singing, and orange glow lights up the sky. I see the beauty of the world. It takes my breath away. There is a kind of music in the air, not a worry or a care. This countryside is all I've ever known. The farm, the tree, the animals, this is the place that I call home. And I just gotta say, this is an amazing day. I simply want to enjoy it, an amazing day, and savor each moment here. The colors, the aromas, the sights and the sounds. I could swear that I'm flying, though my feet are firmly planted on the ground. We're happy, we're thriving, I'm merely surviving. We're all here together, I feel so alive. So once again, let me say, I'm in love with this wonderful, beautiful, perfect, amazing day.
I looked around at where I live. It's much too noisy for me. It's much too crowded, the face is small, the traffic on the busy street. The feeling I get just being in the city, not the kind of awful energy. Time for a change, but one thing remains the same. I know what I'd rather be. Ain't no doubt about it, baby. I am telling you, and I don't mean maybe. I am done with the city life. I have seen the views and the future is right. And I tell you, what I see is a country life for me.
Ain't no doubt about it, baby. I'm a city man. The way I talk, the way I walk, it's a part of who I am. You got the right to choose what you wanna do, but you need to understand. I'm a free spirit, fun-loving, street-smart, disco-dancing, super cool city man.
Let's have a round of applause. Y'all are great.
James. James, I can't leave the city. I'm not moving.
I explain it to your husband. I'm a free spirit, fun-loving, street-smart, disco-dancing, super cool city man.
Sorry, new stepdad, but you can take your family and go live in the sticks. But we are staying right here in Houston.
Dave and Bella, your mother and I are married now, so that makes you my stepchildren. And where I go, we'll all go.
Where are we going, Dad?
Your stepmother inherited a house in a hill country. A huge house with room for four girls and two boys. I am done the oil industry and life in Houston. And I can't take the stress.
James, I understand your job is stressful, but I can't live in the city. What about my ladies' luncheons? We'll lose our spot in a country club.
You don't need a country club. You would be in a real country.
But Dad, I got shop at the Galleria. I have a look to maintain.
I need my McDonald's, Dad. We're gonna eat.
There's a tree. Fresh pecans right off the tree. Imagine pecan pie and blueberry bruises. We'll make the garden and raise some animals.
Eat our own animals? Gross. I'm not a star. Black hair.
Can I have a horse?
Sure, I'll buy you a horse.
Cool.
Oh, what is it about wolves? Are you wolves in the country?
I don't know.
No, just bobcats.
The bobcats will eat Gucci.
Bobcats gonna have snack for Gucci.
Oh, sorry, Paul.
Kids!
Hey!
Well, your family can go. But we are going, right, Mom? We refuse to move. You aren't my real dad, and you can't make me.
Uh-oh.
May, I won't take it.
Bella, we are family now, and we're all in this together.
But, Mom, I can't leave Houston. What about all my friends?
Don't worry. We'll be back by fall. He won't be able to stand it.
I hate country music. I love disco, but I want to stay here in Dallas.
The truck just moved up. The truck just pulled up. Girls, get those pom-poms loaded. Boys, help the movers. The Baxter station wagon will actually leave in 1 hour.
No! Yeah!
And get ready to go back on.
Just put it down. Go that one backstage. Sure. It look like the movie Speed is here. That look like the movie Speed is here.
The house looks like the picture. May, look at that pecan tree.
Wow, what a beautiful tree.
Notice that the house is covered in goats.
What?
Does the house come with the goats or like extra?
Get those filthy animals off our property.
Dave, home, move those goats.
Are they dead or they're sleepy or awake?
Fresh goat meat, Bella. To like McDonald's, princess.
Wake up, goats. Wake up. Wake up. What the?
Are those your goats?
Of course. This is my goat.
What do you got in that cage? Is it a dog or is it a rat?
It's a dog. It's a dog. It's a drill. Did you just catch it?
What should I do with this rivet?
This is our dog. His name is Squishy.
Why is it 12?
I've never seen a tiny little dog with sunglasses.
It's so tiny.
It's so tiny, like the size of a big rat.
Excuse me, are you the neighbors?
God wants to know if we're the neighbors.
Yes.
Well, that depends on who you are.
I'm James Baxter, and this is my wife, Mary Hill Baxter.
I inherited this house. This is my great-aunt's house, and we are moving in.
Your great-aunt, huh?
Yes.
Yikes.
How long are y'all planning on staying?
How's that any of your business?
You've got goat poop on your skull!
We're here in the country. You got a horse?
Not right now. We used to, though. Now, we mostly just got goats.
These are your goats?
Whose those goats would they be?
Get them off my property.
They won't like that.
They won't?
Because that's where they nap.
Nap!
Let's start over. Howdy, neighbors. Where's the back?
Hey, Princess, you have a goat behind you.
Hey. Hi.
Hi.
My name is Sarah. Everyone call me Princess.
What's it doing out here, Princess?
Just looking around. And what are you eating?
Oh.
Are you blues out here?
No, we picked some blueberries for something yummy.
Yes.
Oh, so.
I love to.
And we have a big country, what's up?
Sure. Yummy. Good. Yummy and good.
Yeah, me too.
Matt, Wyatt, your pa needs your help.
Gotta go. Go get half the rest of the blueberries, Princess.
Thank you.
Attention, pecan!
You win? Oh, yeah, right. Ooh. What's up with this rope? Where are you going?
We're going to pick blueberries and pecans.
Dad!
Nice day for farming, eh, Linda? Morning, new neighbors.
Morning.
Give me of this rope.
Oh, that's the property line.
Yeah, that's our property line.
My understanding that tree isn't our property.
Nah, you're mistaken.
Mistaken?
All this is ours.
All this?
Going to pick blueberries and pecans.
Not your tree. See the rope.
Merry King of the land.
Okay, look. I mean, come on. Pa is saying you have the house for crying out loud. We've been growing in corn and hay over this here property for generations. Now you want to come rolling in your station wagon and with a caged rat at best, and wanna boot us off? We have a living to make. Now, Glinda over here, sure, she looks all nice and sweet and potato and everything, but she was just about ready to get her sawed off and run you back to Houston. But, give me a second. But just so you know, I don't know what happened to the rope, but Pa is a good man, and he has just told us to mark out our territory, which we have done.
You ought to be glad my Pa's so nice and neighborly.
Girls, tell your mother to get these to the land. I understand England, but that tree is our property.
You don't want to mess with my dad.
You better move that boat. He's going to sue you.
Try and sue us. We got squatters' rights.
What?
Our goats have been sleeping on this porch here for generations, and now they got no place to take a nap.
She's right. This is our land. Has been forever.
Forever.
Mac, don't give her our pecans. Uncle Junior, your goat's eating the rope.
Girls, we'll find some place for your chickens to forage away from these people.
I got my eye on you.
The goat ate the rope too soon. The goat ate the rope too soon. The rope was... We had to go with it.
Oh, the door. Close the door.
Goats eat rope?
The goats eat everything.
What a fair love is to eat. Hey.
The goats eat 4 pounds of hay a day.
So you have 8 goats, that's 32 pounds of hay a day, which is 224 pounds a week. Do they eat hay all year?
Yes.
Then yes. So that's 224 tons, 365 days a year, which is 81,760 pounds of hay a year. Thank you. County fair.
You don't know what a county fair is?
Are you two brothers?
Yes.
No, yes. We are stepbrothers.
My mom just married his dad, you know.
Did your mom die? Our mom died.
No.
No, she didn't die.
No, she didn't die. They... That divorce. His two.
My parents got a divorce in 78, and then my mom remarried his dad in 79, just after 2 years when Elvis Presley passed away in 1977 on August 16th. Thank you.
Oh, that's weird. You guys have divorced parents?
That's not weird. It happens a lot.
I think your goat ate through the rope.
Yeah, go get to it.
What is that?
Oh, that's a ladybug, silly.
Try to catch it.
Never seen a lightning bug?
I mean, try to catch them.
They're so beautiful.
Mosquitoes, mosquitoes, radioactive mosquitoes. Josh.
Bills from the bill collectors. You owe back rent for this lovely law office.
Yeah, just file with the rest of those bills. I'm working on another plan.
What now? Are you trying to get little old lady to sue over cracks over the sidewalk again?
Hush, little lady. It's bigger than that.
Well, it better be pretty big or you're out of business and I'm out of my job.
Answer it!
Come on. Let's go. Law Office of Mr. Cheatham, how may I help you?
This is a client. Answer it! Oh, I'll do it. No, wait, I'm not supposed to answer my phone. I'm a lawyer. Forget it, I'm doing it myself.
Hello, Law Office of Mr. Cheetah. I'm his brother Klein right now. Can I help you?
Absolutely.
You want to make an appointment? Hang on a minute.
You take that. Yes. Yes. I see. Of course.
Yes.
Settlement dispute? I see. All right, then. We'll be right over tomorrow morning. Assistance, am I right?
Okay. See you soon.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I told you we needed two phones.
Did you get enough caution tape?
It is 40 feet from here to the tree. I calculated the radius of the treetop at 35, so the whole circumference is 2 pi r, which is 220. But if I divide that...
Just hand me the yellow tape.
Okay.
Bella, nail the tape to the tree.
No, Bella.
On the other side. This is our side.
What should I do with the old rope? The ghost chewed it.
Mom, don't you think that the Kaufmans are just going to come out here and move this yellow tape?
Over my dead body. Those hillbillies are staying on their side of property. We're not going anywhere.
But Mom, you said we would have to stay. You said that we'd move. As soon as James got sick of it.
Call him Dad, not James.
You said we wouldn't have to stay.
I know I said that before, but now I'm gonna stay. I'm not gonna be bullied by poorly dressed peasants with bad haircuts. Hurry, come inside before the menial making mosquitoes come out.
Thank you.
You booked these appointments too close together. What are the addresses?
We are at number 1 Kaufman Hollow Drive at 9 o'clock, and then number 300 from row 1 right after.
God admit it. Kaufman Hollow Drive and Farm Road 1 are the same thing.
They are?
These are the houses right here.
Assistance, my wife.
The Kaufmans want to sue the neighbors, the Baxters.
And the Baxters want to sue their neighbors, the Kaufmans.
And you had to give up one of the clients. Which one? The Kaufmans have lived here forever, and the Baxters have more money.
I can't decide.
It's 9 o'clock. Hurry up and decide.
Light bulb. I've decided. I want both. I can't have both, and I'll never know I'm representing them both.
What about when we get to court?
That's the thing. We won't get them to court. I'll get the both of them to agree to a settlement, and I'll just take all their money underneath their own little noses.
That is a bad plan. Why do you have a fake mustache?
Because you never know when you'll need it. Now, be a dear, Miss Dewey, and go knock on the door!
Hello, you must be the lawyer. We've been expecting you.
May I introduce Mr. Cheatham? I'm his assistant, Mrs. Dewey.
Nice to meet you.
Quite a family resemblance. Are there more of you?
8 of us?
Astounding.
This is Mr. Kaufman. I'm his brother, Mr. Kaufman, but everyone likes to call me Uncle Junior. Let's get down to business.
Yes. Shall we go in, Uncle Junior, Mr. Kaufman, into the house to discuss the lawyery things and stuff?
Pa doesn't want lawyers in the house. He wants to talk out here. So please sit down.
Okay. Now, you gave us, our law office, a call about a property dispute. Do you have any documentation?
A deed, perhaps?
No, we don't need a deed. We've been farming this land for over 60 years.
Look around. Our pasture, our pecan tree, our blueberries.
So you have, no documentation at all?
Don't need none. Just ask anyone in this county. This is Kaufman Hollow. It was named after us.
That's true, but this is going to take some time and research to prove that you are indeed the legitimate owners of this land without any of those papers.
Then do it.
Of course. However, Mr. Kaufman, research takes time. And Mr. Cheatham charges by the hour.
Where's the lawyer, Mary? You said 9 o'clock.
I said 9-ish.
I have someone in the car. I'll be right back. Miss Dewey, do whatever you can to get their information to make sure we get a good amount of money from this.
Mr. and Mrs. Baxter, I presume.
You're late.
Sorry, I kind of got lost. Shall we go in and talk about your terms?
The house reeks of pecans. The girls are trying to make pie.
I don't mind the smell.
They bother me. Let's talk out here. I know your clock is ticking. We keep it short. We're suing for ignoring the property lines and causing mental stress to my wife.
I can't stand those people. I am ready to sign an agreement with you right now.
Okay, I'll be right back with the needed paperwork. Just hang on a minute.
The Kaufmans want to talk to you.
Very well. Here, put on this mask, put on this wig, and make sure that you get every single little penny out of them. Get going! So, Uncle Junior, Mr. Kaufman, you have any questions?
how much up front?
I'm Mrs. Dewey, Mr. Cheatham's assistant.
We just want to see the agreements.
Here are the papers to review and sign.
One moment, I'll be right back.
They're ready to sign.
How much did he tell the Kaufmans?
$30 an hour.
$30 an hour? Tell them to get it to $50. Give me away. Now
your
you go
mustache.
To the Kaufmans and get the back, and I'll go to the Baxters.
Your mustache.
Wait, what?
Your mustache.
Sorry, technical difficulties.
No! Come on.
I think everything is in order. Sign here, please.
Mr. Cheatham told me that he can't go any lower than $50 an hour. That he could be sure he is the best. In town.
Here's a check for a retainer. See you in a week.
Thank you.
Here's payment. Down payment or whatever it calls for.
Thank you.
I know. Miss Dewey, let me tell you something about me.
Dewey, you see before you a man who is clever, sly, and smart. Brum-a-rum-a-rum-a-rum-a-rum. At the art of the rickery or chicanery, I'm great, Mr. Swirl, it's true.
It's impossible to have second thoughts about it.
Now be a do-it work. What the? Never had a doubt about it. Now that's the kind of man I am. And sure enough, it went all according to my plan. All according to my plan. I couldn't be more pleased. I played it perfectly, if I do say so myself. All according to my plan. I'm now on easy street.
Now we're on easy street. Don't forget I helped.
Yes, Dewey, your story was helpful to me. But don't you forget who brilliantly conceived it.
Now get over here.
The king of the legal scam. The one and only Flim Flam Man. Yes, it all came together. It all came together. It all came together. According to my plan. No!
Anybody having fun? Yeah, this is such a great night. My name is Paul Rasmussen. We have a lot of visitors with us tonight. Many of you I have not had the privilege of meeting yet, but I would love to. I'm the senior minister here at Highland Park United Methodist Church, and it is a great joy to welcome all of you. We do a lot of things around this church. There are a lot of special days. There are a lot of special nights, but none to me are more special than Spotlight Theater. And this program to see the enormous talent and giftedness that comes out of the hearts and minds and souls of these precious actors is really a special night. Give it up one more time for everybody there in the back. They're going to take a little break. We're going to take a little break in just 1 minute, but I want to take a minute to thank you. I know many of you are here to support your family, your loved ones, and your friends, but also your presence here supports an enormous part of who we are as a church. Our Belong Disability Ministry program here is really one of the bedrock and foundational programs of the church. This is just simply a service that this church is called to provide to the community. It is broad in scope. Not only do we have the Spotlight Theater program, but we have everything from rock bands to Sunday morning worship and services, day classes. Right across the street, we have an entire building called the Tollison Family Activity Center that is tailor-made, engineered, and designed expressly for those with disabilities. And all it is something that we can offer to the community. Your support really, really does matter because all of our programs are 100% free. We give them away to the community, and there's no expectation that anybody that participates has to be part of this church, support this church, give to this church. It is simply a gift to those who need it. So I hope when you leave out of here tonight, for those that are not familiar with it, you'll be inspired and you'll tell everybody because we have a myriad of programs. We'd love for you to come by, take a tour of the facilities, get to meet our staff and all of the volunteers. You can also go online to hpumc.org and read more about it, but it is a really special part of who we are and really could be argued as the heartbeat of our community here at the church. And so thank you for being here. We think so much about what's going on here in Spotlight Theater. About 3 years ago, we thought, wow, we need to tell this story to more communities. We wish more people than just those of you that can fit inside Wesley Hall on two nights in February knew about the great work that was happening through Spotlight. And out of a sheer blessing, I met a young up-and-coming filmmaker named Ricky Townsend, and he introduced me to an Emmy Award-winning producer named Thad Matula. Thad is with us tonight. We are so blessed. Thad, you take a minute and stand up. Thad and I sat down and I said, we've got this program that we're real proud of and we'd love to tell the story. Would it be possible to do a feature-length documentary? And so they came on board and they followed all these young, brilliant actors and actresses around for a little more than a year. It was a challenging time because of COVID and all kind of other things, but they did it and they did it with great integrity and creativity, and we could not be more excited about the product and what is about to happen in our community. So over the course of the last couple of years, Thad has been at work diligently trying to piece together a really wonderful film. It's called Into the Spotlight. We have applied to over 40 different film festivals. That film will be released this spring, and we cannot wait for people literally around the world to see it. And we look forward to all the reception that we hope we'll receive in good favor from the various film festivals. But tonight, you all are incredible lucky because you're going to be the first eyeballs to see the trailer for a feature-length film directed, produced by Thaddeus Matula called Into the Spotlight. So take a look at this.
Get into Spotlight.
I'll make the list of those who made the lottery. It's kind of nerve-wracking.
First one is...
I'm going to actually check and see if I missed a call or anything.
Hello?
I am so excited to let you know you got a spot in our next season of Spotlight Musical Theater.
That's exceptional.
I get to show off my talent and also tell a message.
Spotlight is a theater company with actors who have disabilities.
I'm in.
Hey. I'm in.
I feel so excited to go back and do Spotlight again. I'm not scared at all. Here I come, Dallas.
Have y'all had any ideas about what we could do this play about?
Friendship around the world.
I think that we should do a tribute.
There is a lot of issues with discrimination.
Those actors are the ones from whom the ideas come from that are made into the script.
What if the club singer was a superhero as his alter ego?
Pop into something. Pause, Nancy.
No.
All right, pause. Cut. Are you okay, Nancy?
Why drums? Why?
Every Spotlight production is an original production.
I got so many things I want to do. I got so many things. Come away with me.
Very nice.
Okay,
Lift it up.
Excuse me.
Careful. Someone, chase the facade. Turn it around.
Let's rock the house.
I'm nervous.
I don't even think that I have a disability.
When any given Spotlight production opens, it is a world premiere.
That's a miracle. I can't believe we did it.
Okay, so Hollywood, here we come. Ready or not, we are very, very excited. And what we hope will happen with this film is that it will be spread and seen by many, many people. And maybe some kind of a seed will be planted in their hearts and their minds, and they'll go back to their communities, their nonprofits, their churches, their whatever, and figure out a way to create platforms that give agency to the brilliant giftedness of anyone with disabilities. And we really hope that that takes off. We're very, very excited about it. Here's what you can do to help. See that little QR code? This is kind of awesome. You just shoot a picture of that with your phone. If you can't figure that out, ask one of the sixth graders in the room, and they will tell you how to do it. And it's going to allow you to spread this on social media. So here's what you can do when you leave out of here tonight. Begin to post that on your Instagram, your Twitter account, your Facebook, whatever it is that you do to spread the good news. Because this is going to go pretty fast and furious once spring rolls around. That's how you can help us. And then lastly, just with a bit of privilege, I'd like to thank a couple of other people. Thad is a two-time Emmy winner, but Michelle Cox is a two-time Employee of the Week winner here at the church. And Michelle, are you here? Stand up. So we asked Michelle to figure out how to make a movie, and she has done that, and she has done it with great fanfare and a lot of success, and we're really, really excited about that. And then, of course, Stephanie Newland, who directs our entire Belong Disability program. It's over here. Steph, take a minute. So this is the crew, and you're a family, and I hope you'll tell anyone in the community that can use or need or leverage or enjoy the services of the Belong Disability ministry and program at Highland Park United Methodist Church. It is there for the taking. There is no charge ever, and any family can use it at any time. So find out about it, invite more and more people, and we look forward to the future, and thank you for helping us share the great news about Into the Spotlight that'll be just around the corner. We're going to take about a 10-minute break, and then we're going to come back, and we're going to find out the dramatic conclusion of Who's Hollow. We'll see you in about 10 minutes.
A country song, I love the way it makes me feel. I love a country song, the lyrics and the melody. When I hear one play on the radio, I always want to sing along. Simple and clear, real and sincere, I love a country song. Some folks, they like rock and roll. Some like rhythm and blues. Some say jazz is where it's at. Others like a ragtime tune. But as for me, it's gotta be country. I love a country song. I love the way it makes me feel. I love a country song, the lyrics and the melody. When I hear one play on the radio, I always want to sing along. Simple and clear, real and sincere, I love a country song.
Woo! Way to go, Jim!
Yeehaw!
Jane.
Much obliged.
This is bad. I want to know the guidance.
Why can't I be friends?
Why can't we be friends? You know the song too? My sisters are calling me.
Let's give a round of applause to Jeremiah Kaufman.
Is this an open mic? I mean, can my son come up here and sing a song?
Usher, no harm.
Dave, come up here and let's show him how it's done.
Okay, let's do it. One, two, three, four. I feel a feeling coming on. And that feeling keeps on getting stronger and stronger. When I hear the music playing,
I gotta dance.
It simply carries me away. And your turn, buddies. It's something I got a hold of me. Captures the heart and the soul of me. When I hear the music playing, I gotta dance. Now on to suspicious minds, everybody.
My heavens! That was something.
I was supposed to say my mic thing.
Did you see me dancing?
You see me dancing?
Cool news!
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to introduce you to the Empire team, Mrs. Bailey.
Who are we all applauding for?
That's the mayor's wife. She's going to announce the contest winners.
Why, throwing toss?
No, the best competition for best jam, best pie, best goat.
Goat pie?
No, live goats.
Look what I just bought, moisturizing soap. It smells so good.
Gladys goat soap.
Goat soap.
Thank you all for coming. Our county, the people who had new faces this year, our county is growing. We were only 8 months away. More for more mailing.
Thank you, Mrs. Bailey. Please now the contest winner.
First place for Mary Chandler's and Allie Ackerman. And then the award is her daughter, Jessie. First place from a comprised of Alvin Kaufman. First place from comprised of Glenda Kaufman.
A new category of breast dress dog.
First of breast dress dog goes to Marlene Mountain on a Gucci and disco outfit. And now the category for all mess around goat with a Mac and Wyatt Kaufman. And you're part of the brand new Walkman.
Woo!
Nice.
Now that's a prize. Generated by Mrs. Bailey and Joy the Fair. There's games and food to buy. And an annual show is coming up.
Miss Julie, who is that man lurking by the jam table?
I never seen him before.
He's not having a butter. He's still in the jam.
Did somebody say steal? Did somebody need a lawyer? What?
We are talking about that gentleman over there.
What, that hobo?
I've seen him at the fair before.
I've met him before.
What? You know that old guy?
Yes. I met him on the Fat Country Road. He lives in these parts for many years, but keeps it himself. And no, he doesn't need a lawyer.
Aww.
Rain toss.
I haven't done this since I was a wee little boy.
All you have to do is stand behind that yellow line and throw it in. If you win, you win a prize.
Watch this, plebs. That was just a fluke. That was awesome. What?
Loser prize, vote for Bob Bailey for mayor for next year.
What?
Hey, sir, do you want to try this game? Just stand behind the yellow line. All you have to do is win a prize, bro.
Dingy.
Loser prize, vote for Bob Bailey.
All right.
Me, I try.
So sorry, you lost. Here's a vote for Bob Bailey bumper sticker.
Wait just a minute. This game is rigged!
Move along, mister.
No, I ought to report you to the authorities, and I'll sue you until you are crying pennies out of your eyes. And, hey, get back here! He believes this.
Is there a goat soap for sale?
You like goat soap?
It's excellent for the skin.
Oh, goat soap is that way.
Hey, I'll try ring toss. Hey, where did the ring toss guy go?
I don't know.
You see me flying?
Okay, sing your song, ready? Go.
Do not take this mic. Wise men say, and a true.
Let me finish.
Washing, so I can't help falling in love with you.
Me, Elvis, I want to shake, rattle, and roll. I want to be Elvis. Sing with a feeling deep down. in my soul. He's so cool. Well, he got style. And the way he moves makes the ladies wild. And I wanna be like him. Like a billionaire, burning up. I wanna be like Elvis more than anything. Because he's the king.
I gotta tell you, Glenda, that might have been the best kind of fair we've ever had. I mean, seriously, that guy Paul was funny with the tablecloth.
Woo! He was laughing at us, not with us. He was making fun of the fair.
Oh, come on, Glenda. Give him a chance.
Maria, you better throw that ghost up away. When Mom finds out that it's made out of Kaufman goats, she's gonna have a fit.
It's good for the skin, and it smells nice.
Oh, smells goaty to me.
No, it doesn't.
They are laughing at us.
I got the claps.
Come on, guys.
I'm gonna take down that yellow tape and tear it to shreds!
We can put another Rebecca on our side.
You know that they'll just pull the rope down again. We'll end up doing this over and over and over and over and over.
We can tie the rope tighter.
Up here, up here.
Ah, that won't work.
Why did they have to come here?
You know, that house never really belonged to us.
It was empty for years. They abandoned it.
Well, now they're back. For good or for bad?
For bad.
They are eating all of our pecans.
The ghosts have nowhere to go to grace.
Now the ghosts have gas of empty pokeweed.
The chicken.
Pokeweed, huh?
Sorry.
And the chicken
hate the cooped up.
My chicken needs one well free.
Ellie, did you say that the goats are gassy from the pokeweed?
That's going to flavor.
That's going to fill the milk.
And ruin my next batch of soap.
Hang on! I have an idea for a fence that the Baxters won't dare to touch. Listen to this.
What are we doing? Gosh.
Oh, howdy. Hey, howdy, new neighbors. Wonderful night for a stroll, am I right? Okay, you all have a good night now.
You put the goat soap in the bathroom?
Yes, and your mom uses it.
She told me she loved it. She asked me where it came from.
Well, what did you say to her?
I told her it came from David Morgan's.
What in the name of heaven is this?
What's that spell? What's that horrible spell?
Ah, morning. Howdy-do! What do you think of our new goat fence, neighbor?
The goats are on our property. Just try to move them.
What is that awful smell? I'm gonna barf!
Boys, move those goats!
Oh, no.
I can't breathe.
I don't think I can.
I don't think I can't.
That's the most despicable thing I've ever seen. Poisonous goat farts in our house.
You are reason that our goats were in the field with the pokeweed.
Despicable is your wife aiming poison spray at the lightning bugs. Hmm.
You did this? Look. I think we can solve this peacefully.
Yeah? You hired a lawyer to sue us.
You did too.
You keep hammering ropes.
You keep hammering most of my pecan tree.
Your pecan tree? Well, you ripped it out and hammered in your yellow tape.
That's our tree. I mean it.
Wrong! That's our tree! No, I didn't say fight!
Yeah, there he is!
Who are those guys?
I don't know.
Those are the lawyers you're talking to?
You did too?
Yeah.
Bad timing.
Back to the car!
That cheap! How much money did you give him?
Our money!
Hey!
Too late! I'm off to Cuba! Thanks for the money, suckers!
What?
I can't stop me!
Too, my God.
That's our tree! Get off our property!
What the? The tree!
The tree!
Oh no! The tree! It's broken!
Our tree.
I am so sorry about Mr. Cheatham. I'd give you the money back, but I don't have the money. I don't know what to do about the property disagreement, but I know someone who lives up the hill. If he's willing to help, if y'all are willing to try.
I can't believe you make us hike out here in the middle of nowhere.
My feet hurt. If I knew we were climbing a mountain, I would have worn more sensible shoes.
There ain't nothing sensible about ya.
Don't talk to my wife that way.
Wait, I'll be real careful talking to Glenda like that.
Enough! Y'all are going to come here. So we are going to see this guy and see if he will help. Hello? Mr. Rumpelshay? Are you here?
Who's here?
Sorry to bother you, but we...
Yeah, I was telling you, I know why you're here. I felt the tree crack.
You felt it?
Yes, that tree is very sacred and very special to me. 100 years ago, you and I lived next to each other. But like you, they could not stand each other. As the conflict had been fighting for so long, no one knows why they're fighting anymore. But the hatred was deep. As fate would have it, that Billy Maxwell lived with Anne Marie Kaufman, and she and his she with him. And now their families, however, forbade it, but love only grew stronger. When they came of age, they went to the courthouse to get married, only that would end the feud. Unfortunately, it only made the families get angrier. So Billy's parents locked him in the attic and had a ring in the basement. One day, they tried to climb out of the attic to get to Anne Marie's coffin, but a trellis broke and he fell to his death. When Anne Marie learned of his death, her cries were relentless. He didn't have his vows, they would never fight again. To honor Billy, of course he was fighting on the property line, so that by shared nurture to both families, and that commitment to the connection to love over hate. That's all what happened 100 years ago.
Wow. Okay, so you're saying the tree belongs to both families.
How heavy, sir. It belongs to the family, your family, because you're all into Anne Marie and Billy Baxter.
What?
How do you know all this?
Because Billy became my brother and my sister Anne Marie, and I helped plant that tree.
What?
Yes, you're all part of just one big family.
But that would mean you are...
123.
What?
And you're bickering and paying us killing our tree.
Oof. Well, I feel just awful.
Me too.
What can we do?
Make peace with neighbors, or live your lives in harmony. I mean, you see a stranger, remember he is part of your family.
I have an idea.
I have an idea.
Me too.
I know how to put families together. Let's go home.
Thank you so much.
Kaufman, it's been an amazing day.
Mr. Baxter. There is a kind of music in the air, not a worry or a care. This countryside is all I've ever known. The farm, the tree, the animals. This is the place that I call home.
This is an amazing day. We simply want to enjoy it. An amazing day. And there is love in now.
We're thriving.
We're grooving. We're driving.
We're all here together.
And we're
all
feeling fine. So once again, let us say we're in love with this wonderful, beautiful, perfect, amazing.
and gentlemen, the county fair folks, Elizabeth Crook, Cooper Zima, Leah Badalora, and Jesse Smith. Bow, Jesse. Jesse, bow. There we go. There we go. The lawyers, Michael Susans and Cindy Johnston. The Baxter family, Hannah Ryerson, Sarah Zalays, Ana Lucia Macias, Efren Lopez, Cole Warren, and Caroline. Take a bow. The Kaufmans, Jacob Kunko, Katie Boone, Chrissy Allison, Gracie Kyle, Julia Ballou, Cormac Curran, and Luke Andrews. The parents, Chris Thompson, Jeremy Criswell, Beth Coe, and Quentin Parker. And starring Justin Waters as Rubius Rinpoche. The volunteers, come out and give a wave, volunteers. There's a lot of them. And everybody, the band. Our beautiful film production crew. We have an amazing artistic staff, support staff, and of course, the Highland Park United Methodist Church. Thank you so much.